this has been way too long, in my opinion. Welcome. The last two pieces that you just heard were some traditional Scottish tunes. The first one was Neil Gow's lament for his second wife. I'm not certain how many laments he's written for his wives, but this is his second one. And following that, we had a boy's lament for his dragon. Two real traditional Scottish tunes. And they were performed by the folk band and Fiddelium together. Up next, we have something that's very, very high on the cute factor. This is a Suzuki group that's put on by Trish. Trish is one of the directors, and who else do we have here? Alexander Lee. This is just way too distracting. This is the most adorable thing. Suzuki students start when they're 3 years old. I think we have some three-year-olds in here. In fact, I think the cellist down on the end is three. Is that right? Yes. And the Suzuki Suzuki method is a method of teaching where the kids learn to make a beautiful tone through lots and lots of repetition and memorization of repertoire. And you will actually not believe what you're about to hear. It's pretty impressive. Okay, I think we're about ready to launch this thing into orbit here. Okay, here we go.
Suzuki, could I have your eyes?
Thank you.
You've never heard the twinkles so good. That was fantastic. We'd like to thank Alexander Lee and Nick Ross for bringing their students here to play with us this evening. Fantastic. Okay, so we're gonna give the kids just a couple of moments to put their violins away quickly and then come back into the audience here. So the next thing I'd like to talk about is our folk band. So the folk band here is folk band is a group of violin players, fiddle players, of all ages, and as well as there are family participants in here, which is really, really interesting. There's Sarah and Aurora and Matt and Elise in here, and Evelyn and Jubilee, Jonas, Marique and Julian. Like there's families that play together in this group, and it's really, really a wonderful thing to see. I didn't really get a chance to make music with my kids, but it's never too late to start. It's never too late to start. And you'll see a lot of the adults in this group started as adults. What's an adult? Let's see, Doug's an adult. Doug, when did you start? How old were you when you started?
62.
My oldest student that I started on the violin was 80, and she could play, which is just amazing. And we have the longest lasting member in the folk band here. Her name is Edna. Edna's back here. Edna's gonna come to the front of the stage here. Edna's been playing with the group for 16 years. Fantastic. Okay. Do we have some kids trickling in yet? I don't think so. Does that mean I have to kill more time? Oh my goodness. All right, well, let me tell you a little bit about the way folk band works. So, folk band is an all ages, all instruments type of group. We meet weekly during the school year. My wife Trish, which is somewhere around here somewhere, she writes all of the arrangements. So she picks tunes, she writes harmonies for them, she successfully tortures us all year long with her creations. It's quite spectacular. So she writes all the music, she scores all the music, she notates it, she records everything. I throw a little bit of piano and stuff on it there, just to make it sound good. And people listen to the recordings and they learn all of their notes, basically offline, not in class. They learn all their notes offline, and then we come together every week and we make music. And it's culminating in this concert this year. And normally, you know, we would be performing in seniors' homes and that sort of thing, but it just hasn't been able to happen in recent times. But now we are so glad, so happy to be back in front of this audience. Thank you so much for coming. Okay, I think we should just play. What do you think? Shall we? I've blabbed long enough here. Here we go.
Thank you.
Okay, now it's my turn to blah, 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 and fill some time while we strike some furniture. And I would like to introduce you, Fiddelium. We are very proud of these kids. I'm sure all of you are here and have read all of the social media and newspaper articles and all of those things that celebrate all of the accomplishments of this group. But in case you don't know, Fiddelium was formed about 10 years ago. We don't actually have a complete fix on that because it started, we didn't actually know it would become such a big deal when we started this group, but I think it was about 10 years ago. And it started out as a group for very advanced teen players who wanted a little bit more of a challenge than folk band was giving them. And so we started this group, and basically what we wanted from them was a match to the extra work that it takes for the directors to put together a group like this. So, I don't know, Fiddelium, do you work kind of hard? Yeah. This is a very demanding undertaking for these kids. They work for many hours a week. And the result is that they are two-time champions of the CBC Music Class Challenge, where they there are hundreds and hundreds of entries to that contest every year, and Fiddelium has won twice and has been top 10 finalists every single time that they've entered, so that's one exciting thing. They also get to participate in fun events like the Youth Fiddle Summit that we just had that you'll hear a little bit more about, and of course, recording their first CD, which we are going to shamelessly pitch at you all night long. So, we're going to start this off with a set of two Canadian tunes. These tunes were written by a Canadian fiddle player named Gordon Stobie. And this arrangement was written by an alumni member of Fiddelium, whose name is Quinn Etheridge Pedden. You may know him as Quinn with one N. He's a well-known performer in town. And this is Carabella and Last Dance.
Thank you.
introducing you to some of the members of the group here. Here we have the A team. They said, well, why don't you call us the A team? Alistair and Ava. Alistair and Ava.
Yeah, hello everybody, I'm Alistair.
I'm Ava.
Yeah, and so we're the A team, obviously, yeah.
Clearly.
Yeah, obviously. So we were asked to think of something that we both had in common, to talk in front of you, and the number one thing that we have in common is mountain biking. Yeah, obviously, other than violin. So I've been mountain biking for a really long time, I think since I was in grade 4 or 5, I think, yeah. And I like to do kind of enduro stuff, a lot of riding in Westwood and then just by my house.
He also almost placed in BC Provincials last week. His bike broke, that's why he didn't place.
Oh yeah, I've used that excuse before.
I like to ride near my house more cross country, but I did my first enduro race last weekend and it was really fun.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much.
Playing are Vessenvalsen and Triple Fiddle, or Death by Triple Fiddle.
All right, let's play them for them.
Thank you. Questions, but I'm just going to leave you out to dry. Actually, before you say anything, I just want to draw attention to the fact you're looking at a room full of people who would rather die than stand in front of all of those people and talk at a microphone, so hats off. So, Ben and Olivia, I've known you for a long time. I'm going to put Ben on the spot and tell you that I started Ben on violin when he was three years old. How old are you now, Ben?
15.
So, wow, we go way back, you and I. This is very cool. And Ben has actually been part of every single Port Theatre show. The first time you were a twinkler.
Yep.
And here you are now. And Olivia, this is your first Port Theatre show.
It is.
So far, what do you think? Are you going to stick around for the rest of it?
Oh, totally, yes.
So do you remember, what was the first piece you learned for Fiddle?
Oh, I think I learned a set of three different tunes, but I think the first one I learned was Lady Anne Montgomery.
Lady Anne Montgomery, okay. And has it gotten easier to memorize the tunes over the years?
Yeah, I'd say so.
Yeah, excellent, okay. And Ben, my question for you. Talk about the choreography. What are some things that you really love about the choreography? Are there any tricks that you have for to help people
study
the choreography? Study
the
choreography.
That's the only way it works for me.
Well, I'm going to announce right now, Ben, you get to be our choreographer next year.
Oh, cool.
Okay, so why don't you tell us what our next tune is?
Alright, so our next tune is going to be Top of My School. It was written by a young musician, I think 17, in Ontario, named Catherine Lynn Rose. It was our entry into the CBC Music Class Challenge, and we won with that entry. Yeah.
Thank you.
bring the folk band back on stage here. We may have to go rustle them up here. We're going to bring folk back on stage, but while we get them up here, I just want to talk a little bit about the CD project that Fiddelium was involved in over the last couple of years. We didn't do any real performing, so we decided to engage in a CD project. And at the time, there were 15 kids in the group, and we got them into our studios. We had two recording studios set up, one in my wife's studio, Trisha's studio, and one in my studio. My name, by the way, is Jeff. Jeff. And we got the kids in one at a time. So we had backing tracks all laid out for them, and then we got them in one at a time, and they all recorded their parts. So, you know, 15 individual takes of their parts. And then, as you can imagine, they weren't all playing together at the same time, and it's kind of hard to kind of lock together. So there was a tremendous amount of magic that went into really lining everybody up. It was quite a big project, but it turned out fabulous. And CD could be yours for the low price of $10. And we have a big sale on today. If you buy three, they're only $30. Yes, it's the deal of the century. Speaking about music, we're almost ready to go here. Speaking of music, if you're a serious music listener, you should be listening to your music on vinyl. Vinyl. I'm telling you, it's a whole new experience for anybody who hasn't done it before. And there is a great little shop here right in town on 33 and a third Victoria Crescent. It's called Sound Heritage, and they sell all kinds of vinyl. You should check it out. Okay, I you know, honestly, I do the repairs for them. I fix their stereos and stuff, so it's a bit of a shameless plug. But buy their records there. They're fantastic. Okay, I think we're ready to go here. Okay, here we go. Thank you.
both sides of the stage. That's a long stage. So one of the wonderful things that came of, how can I put this without uttering the word? 2 years of not being able to make music with other people. We vowed we weren't going to say the word tonight. One of the really wonderful things that came of that is it forced us to move online with some of our teaching activities, and groups like folk band weren't possible, obviously, for part of the last 2 years. And so we moved some of our group classes onto the Zoom format, which at first we weren't really super pleased with. But in the end, it turned into something really lovely because now we have two Zoom classes that have students from across Canada, across the United States, who've never met, who are now making music together, learning the same songs as one another, making friends that, you know, when they start traveling, they have people to visit all over the continent, which is really, really what music is all about, right? Connecting with people. So joining us on stage now are some of the members of that Zoom class. We should make a little bit more room for them. Let's just bring you a little bit further forward. This is about 30% of our intermediate Zoom class, with members from up and down Vancouver Island and the Lower Mainland. And we're going to play two lovely tunes to send you into intermission, where I heard there's a CD available. just a rumor. The first tune you're going to hear is called the Sunday's River Waltz. And it's going to be followed up by a tune from the Old Crow region of the Yukon. It's called Saturday Night Hoedown. It came to us by a tune collector named Boyd Benjamin.
Thank you.
I have to pick the microphone that doesn't require holding. My hands are full. I want to thank Folk Band in particular for being very patient with the format of this show. They work all year long. They prepare the 7 or 8 numbers that they're involved in the show. But they have to go upstairs. They don't actually get to see the rest of the show. So when they leave here, each time they go upstairs, they don't get to see the stage. They don't even really get to hear what's going on. So that's a real feat, especially for the young ones in the front row. So big thumbs up to Folk Band. For those of you who are... missed our chance to talk to the audience that would actually be interested in this, but if you were in the lobby at intermission, you may have noticed the Nanaimo Fiddle Society had a table set up, and there was information there about the Nanaimo Fiddle Society summer camp. This is a camp that runs from August 2nd to August 5th in North Nanaimo at Trinity Catholic Church. Totally suitable for any beginner to advanced fiddle player, but you know, if you play the viola, I'm going to say yes. You may have to convince Jeff on that one. If you play an acoustic instrument and you're interested in attending the summer camp, please let us know. The other thing to keep in mind is that Folk Band, that you've seen come on and off stage, is a component of the summer camp. So if you play guitar or a non-bowed string and you'd like a chance to try out that class, you can do it in a short little bite, August 2nd to 5th in North Nanaimo. One thing I'd like to acknowledge before we get on to the rest of the show is that we are missing two really dearly missed members of Fiddelium tonight, and that is Leo and Lua, who were on board with us when our original date was March 5th, but because we had to change our date, unfortunately they are in Interlaken, Germany tonight, so they are not with us. So we're sending our love to Lua and Leo and their family in Germany. We wish they were here, and we are going to play a tune that Leo actually scored for this group. It's called Hello, Nice to Meet You. Thank you. Shanann, right?
And I'm Katie McCullough.
Yeah. So one thing that we found out about each other is that we both have a love for skiing.
Yes.
Yeah. So where do you love to ski, Katie?
My favorite place to ski is the local mountain, which is Mount Washington. Mm-hmm. I ski there a lot with my family. How about you?
Well, my family and I love to ski at a place called Big White in Kelowna. We love to go there like every single year because it has really good snow and it's just great.
Fresh powder.
Exactly.
Okay, so.
So nobody yet has talked about the CD. So I want each one of you to share a little something about the process of recording the CD. I think the one thing that stood out to me was listening to the CD afterwards, because it was very cool to hear all this play, like, as an audience member. Because when we're up here playing, we don't really necessarily know how we sound like, because we're kind of like, you know, we're playing, so we don't really pay attention to that. So kind of listening to how much work we've put into it and see what the actual final product is really cool.
Yeah, we made this during COVID, and I think it was really the first time in a year of working on this project that we actually got to hear what we sound like together.
Yeah.
Because we were practicing at home, alone, with no one else, just listening to your one harmony part. It was kind of sad, especially since it was written to be played together. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Should they buy a CD?
Yeah, I think you should buy a CD, because we worked very hard. Called Hymn to Freedom, which is actually another song we won for CBC Music Challenge. Yeah.
It was written by Oscar Peterson.
Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Finally, those two tunes were called Owen Jardine and Between. And now we have two special people.
My name's Nora, and I am 14 years old.
My name is Morgana, and I am 16 years old.
Now, these two young ladies share something in common. They both have interesting pets. Interesting pets. Can you tell us about your most interesting pets?
I have four goats, four pet goats. They're very fun. We train them to do tricks and stuff, and they're also very snuggly.
I used to have a lizard called Penny, which is a bearded dragon, which means when they get mad, their skin pops out like a beard, and it's very strange looking.
I had some goldfish once. My goldfish did tricks though.
What did they do?
Well, so here's what they did. They pooped in the water, and then the water drained out into these rocks where they grew greens like lettuce. Yeah, so they would poop, and I would pump it into. They were magic goldfish.
My lizard did not do that.
I wouldn't want to see it if it could. Okay, we have some more tunes coming up, don't we?
Yes. The next tune that we'll be playing is a set of three tunes called 5, 6, 7 that Trish actually arranged and that we played for a Fiddle Summit a few years ago.
And then the set after that is Blue Ribbon Reel and Square Dance in Soweto. The first tune is written by Daniel Lapp and the second one is by Oliver Shore. Hope you enjoy them.
Thank you.
this is Mia.
Hello, my name's Mia Stefliak. I'm part of Fiddelium. I don't know.
How old are you, Mia?
I'm 12 years old.
12 years old. Okay. It shouldn't be possible.
Unfortunately, it is.
So this is your first port theater show?
Not my first one, but...
Well, in Fiddelium, it's
yeah,
your first
in
one.
In Fiddelium.
But how were you on stage before?
So a few years back, I was this girl, like I was Annabelle in like this violin thing with the same people here.
Plus Rick Scott.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, like, I don't know. But like I sang a little song and like I had to practice playing really badly on the violin. Yeah.
You could have just asked me to do it. I would have played badly for you.
Yeah, I didn't need lots of practice, but you know, play.
Okay, I gotta ask you a question. Now I read something about you and NASA. What's the relationship there?
Yeah, so I won a contest a little while back for NASA. It was like this art contest where you had to draw something about basically space for like this calendar thing, and I got first place for my category.
There were 700 entries.
I did not know that.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
I just got an email saying that I won, so.
Wow. You know, you and I actually have something in common.
And we
we do have that in common.
Yeah.
No, you know, I have a link to space as well.
Oh.
I do.
You live in space?
Okay, now somebody out there is laughing. I do. Actually, I do. And I brought my sister, actually.
Oh, I have one of those too.
Actually, works for Chris Hadfield. Oh, you got this book?
Yes,
oh,
I already got
well,
it signed.
I'll give it to somebody else then. First person to the front of the stage. Oh, look at that. Sorry, it's not signed.
Well, it's still free, I guess. So.
CD.
We spent a lot of time working on it.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
All right. Okay. We have another tune.
Yeah.
It's called
Boxing Reel.
The Boxing Reel. And then we're gonna bring the folk band up and we're gonna wrap this baby up.
Yep. With a song called Flying Squirrel.
All right.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're at our final number. We're at our final number. The last number that we're going to perform for you is called Flying Squirrel. But before we do that, we just want to thank a few people here, the Port Theater staff and volunteers for making this all happen. Thank you so, so much. For the sound, the lighting, the stage, front of house, tickets. We also like to thank the Nanaimo Fiddle Society for manning the table at the front of house, and Douglas for his backstage leadership. Thank you, Douglas.
I would like to thank the Suzuki families, many of whom are not in my studio. I'm really thankful that they agreed to be part of this. And thank you also to Nick Ross and Alex Lee for participating with their students. I'd like to thank Dirk Heydemann, who's been capturing images tonight. And you know, it's always a good time to consider getting a family portrait done. So if you're looking for a photographer, you might look up Dirk Heydemann of HA Photography. He's running around here somewhere. And also thank you to Kelly Adam for taking video tonight. We're so happy to have you here. Thank you to all of the performers who worked very, very hard and weathered very difficult 2 years to make wonderful music together tonight. We respect and honor the fact that we live in a time when it's sometimes hard to venture out into large crowded auditoriums. We are so thankful for every one of you for being here tonight, supporting live music and supporting this community of players. Thank you so much.
And it's my turn to thank Jeff and Trish on behalf of Fiddelium and Folk Band and the Repertoire Group. I don't know whether you know, we're having a lot of fun. Up here on the stage, I just asked everybody whether they were having fun, and all the kids said, yeah, yeah, yeah. And they would, there's some people in the second row and maybe the third row who were aspiring to be in the front row someday. They're really looking forward to coming back. And I want to celebrate the twinkles. I paid attention. Did you notice that there were two sets of twins in the front row with the little twinkles? That's just so special. There's mothers and daughters and fathers and sons, and we all appreciate Trish and Jeff. You bring community to this stage. Thank you so much.